Samsung Galaxy S9 water damage. Today we are going to explore all the steps to repair a water damaged device. First, we remove the back cover to access the motherboard. Hello everyone, I'm Adriana and today with Leonardo we are going to carry out an interesting repair and see how much to charge to our final client for a job like this. First tip. When a water damaged device comes to your workshop, immediately disconnect the battery connector. In this way, we prevent further damage to the motherboard and, in particular, short circuits. Next, we remove all the screws from the middle case and the NFC antenna. These are the device's two coaxial cables. We remove the SIM tray and carefully we remove the motherboard of the device. Now we carry out a thorough visual inspection with the microscope for signs of humidity and corrosion. Signs of humidity can be seen here. In the battery connector, we also find a sulfated area. These shields show signs of oxidation. Due to corrosion, this capacitor has detached from the motherboard. With a good microscope, we collect all possible information. This step is fundamental in any repair. We proceed to solder the capacitor, apply a little flux and with the hot air station at 380 Celsius degrees and 10% airflow, we solder it. Be sure to reduce the airflow to a minimum to prevent the capacitor from moving and achieve a strong and shiny solder. We use a piece of cotton and contact cleaner to remove the sulfate from the motherboard. I prefer to clean the affected areas little by little rather than submerging the motherboard in ultrasonics. Depending on the case, we'll use one method or other. If the motherboard is totally damaged, we use an ultrasonic cleaner at 60 Celsius degrees for a deep cleaning. Thank you. The screen connector also shows sulfate, so we'll clean it. Once the cleaning is done, we try to turn on the device. To properly power it up, we use a recycled battery connector. With 10 flex, we can power up most Android devices. If you like this type of content, give it a strong like. Thank you! The device powers up correctly, but it doesn't charge the battery. Those who have seen our course will know where to look for the fault. We proceed to remove the two shields in search of corrosion. This shield we use the hot air station at 400 Celsius degrees and 40% airflow. The key is to lever with a surgical scalpel using the blade number 11. By applying a little force, we can easily remove the shields as the solder lid of the component has not yet reached its melting point. For this second shield, I prefer to cut it with the help of the precision cutter pliers. I prefer not to apply too much heat to the CPU. In the description of this video, I leave you the best precision pliers with more than 3,500 sales and a batch of 10 units with almost 9,000 sales. Delivery to Spain around 10 days. If you work on a mobile repairs, you can't miss this tool. Here we observe quite a bit of corrosion, especially in areas where more current is handled. Everything has its logic. We carefully clean the area with contact cleaner and a piece of cotton. To improve the affected area, we apply a little flux and solder paste, which allows us to reactivate the old solder lid. We use 350 Celsius degrees and 40% airflow on the hot air station. Finally, we carefully clean the area and test the device. For this repair, we'll charge around 70 euros, a suitable price for this type of breakdown. If you need extra income, invest time in your training. It's a clean and comfortable job, and in Spain, there is a high demand in this sector. Just take a look at the job offers. A good technician can earn a good salary every month. Our device seems to charge correctly. The yellow triangle is due to the absence of the NFC antenna. We place it and we check the device again. In this way, we have managed to solve the device problem. Guys, he is Leonardo, and this has been today's video. See you in the next one. Bye bye!